Yes, guys, welcome back. We have been discussing about Ind AS 116 and we are towards the last leg of Ind AS 116 discussion, where we talk about a certain amendment which was inserted in 2020. Now, this amendment has come into picture or has come into play because of the primary objective of solving the problem due to COVID. Now, COVID has created plenty of problems to business enterprises, and these enterprises which have been troubled with COVID have now been given certain rent concessions by their lessors. This is a common principle. Look at how COVID started. The COVID started probably in India somewhere around March, where you find that significant lockdowns were actually placed and businesses were seriously interrupted. If you look at the zero risk policy of IT companies on today's day, none of the IT companies is actually operating from their offices. Now, if you look at even the multiplexes and the cinema halls, most of the cinema halls have been shut over the last 16 to 18 months, majorly due to this COVID. Now, due to this particular problem, there is a particular clause in every rent agreement called as force majeure. This force majeure is basically a simple logic saying that if there is any unforeseen circumstances or anything which is created by God, we normally cannot pay the rent for a particular period. That is what it clearly said. Generally, this concept of force majeure normally applies in case of an earthquake or in case of any other natural calamity. Now, even due to COVID, this particular force majeure has become effective. And that gives a right to the lessee to forego a certain period of rent, probably for about 3 months or 6 months, or the lessor might himself come up with saying that I will give you a rent concession. Now, whenever this particular aspect happens, when there is a rent concession or when there is a foregoing of a rent for a particular period, it does come into this picture of your lease modification, change in the timing of lease rental. Change in the amount of lease rental definitely will require a lease modification. If you remember modifications to a lease, we have seen lease modifications divided into three parts. One, where it was considered as a separate lease, if there is an additional asset and the price of the the increase in the lease rentals is exactly equal to your standalone selling price, then I would have treated it as a separate lease. But if it is not a separate lease and just an adjustment amendment to the existing lease, then there are two situations possible. One is decrease in scope. Decrease in scope is basically where you reduce the lease term or you surrender a part of the right of use asset. ROU asset in part has been surrendered. Or any other amendments like change in the timing, change in the discount rate, changing the possibility of amending the lease or postponing the lease, renewal option becomes exercisable or not. So a lot of things have happened which might require you to do a lease modification. We have discussed about this lease modification under Ind AS 116. Now, what is this particular relief which is provided as an amendment due to COVID? Let's understand. Practical, expedient, available to lessee, as COVID relief. Now, what is this practical expedient which is available to the lessee as COVID relief? Now, let's understand what this particular scheme is talking about. What do you mean by practical expedient? It is a relief from certain or a relaxation from certain paragraphs of the standard. If you remember, we did come across this practical expedient when we were talking about a contract having a lease and a non-lease element together, where he said, the lessee can take a practical expedient to treat both the lease and non-lease element together as one single lease component. This we have discussed, and the word practical expedient, we have applied it there. Now it is within the same Ind AS 116. Once again, we are coming across this relief given in the form of practical expedient. Now what is this relief and where is it available? I'll tell you where it is available first. It is applicable if, point number one, lease rentals have substantially remain the same or have reduced for the payments which fall due. Up to 30th of June 2021. So this relief is applicable only up to 30th of June 2021 if the lease rentals have substantially remained the same or have significantly reduced. Increase in lease rentals do not have any point regarding your practical applicability or your practical expedient relief under COVID. Second, no substantial change in any other conditions of lease. Where there is no substantial change arising due to a change in the condition of lease, like change in lease term, surrendering of a part of an asset. So all these are substantial changes in conditions of lease. If there is no such change, only change which is applicable is for lease rentals, and those lease rentals have either remained the same or have significantly reduced up to the date of 30th of June 2021, then this practical expedient is applicable. Now let's see. In general situation, where COVID starts striking, these COVID lockdowns started somewhere in the month of March 2020. Correct? So due to this, what could be the possible effects which have happened? One, I'm talking about the possible effects, okay? First point, either the lessee has left the premises, expiry of lease. I don't want to continue in the premises. I don't want to pay your lease rental. Thank you. I'll leave from here because due to COVID, my operations are completely locked down or my operations have ceased to exist on today's date. So there's no point for me to continue in the same premises. I would rather exit the premises and leave and start working from home. Expiry of lease is nothing but termination of lease. Under this, as a termination policy, I would have derecognized the lease liability. You've terminated it, right? So you can derecognize the lease liability because there is no obligation for you to pay lease rentals over lease term, and at the same time even the ROU asset, even your ROU asset is also being derecognized, while the difference is transferred to P&L. The difference between the lease liability and the ROU asset When they are derecognized, it should be transferred to P&L. What is the entry that you write? I record the entry as lease liability account debit to ROU asset. The difference I would have transferred it to P&L. If in case there is an expiry of lease. If in case there is an expiry of lease. Or I might surrender a part of ROU asset. Surrender a part of ROU asset. Earlier, I have occupied 2 floors of a building. Today, I have learned to work from home. So, I began negotiation with the lessor and I said, I don't want one floor. You take off this one floor, I am happy with it. I will only continue with one single floor. Or number 2, I might have reduced the lease term. Earlier, the lease term was about 10 years. Now, I find that there is a significant uncertainty for me to continue up to 10 years. Or it was 7 years and there was an extension or renewal for 3 more years. I thought it was reasonably certain for me to renew. But unfortunately, today, I believe renewal is not certain because I have been significantly affected by COVID. I would rather want to leave the premises after 7 years. I do not want to exercise the extension option. In both these cases, I would normally call it as decrease in scope. Whenever there was a decrease in scope, I would reduce ROU asset proportionately with the proportion of decrease in the scope. Earlier it was 2 floors, now it is 1 floor. So the carrying value of the asset should be divided by 2. To that extent, the ROU asset has reduced. Earlier the asset had a lease term of 10 years. Now it is only 7 years. So if it was 10 years, 100 was the carrying value. Now if it is 7 years, what is the carrying value? 100 into 7 by 10. So this way I will reduce the ROU asset proportionately. And I'll also reduce lease liability. The difference I would charge to P&L. This we have already seen. One more we have seen where there is a change in particular or the change in the value of lease. It could also arise, instead of expiring the lease due to COVID or surrendering a part of lease asset due to COVID, or where there's a reduction of lease term due to COVID, I could also have a situation where I could have reduced lease rentals or I could have either reduced the lease rentals or revise the timing of lease rental. Instead of paying on a monthly basis, I would say, please, I can't pay it on monthly basis. You defer this term. This 6 months or 8 months or 9 months. Let's say I'm running a PVR show, a PVR multiplex. So what will I say? During the period where I'm not allowed to run, whatever is the amount of lease, you carry forward and you collect it in the future periods. This is what I'm saying. So there's a reduction in lease rental or they revise the timing of lease rental. In such case, we come across a very peculiar treatment where reduce lease liability and also reduce ROU asset with same amount. here there will not be any difference which arises. We have already discussed these concepts under modification of lease. We have already seen this concept. Now, where is this particular COVID relief being applied? Only if the lease rentals are substantially remain the same or have reduced for payments which fall due up to 30th of June 2021, having no substantial change in any other conditions of lease. That means not in the first situation, not in the second situation, but the relief is only applicable in the third situation. This is where I can apply the practical expedient or relief which is available due to COVID. Clear? Let's see what happened. I'll give you certain examples. Let's say my lease term was 10 years. Just a second, guys. If this is original and this is new or revised lease rentals, revised lease, is it applicable? Let's look at it. Let's take certain examples, compare between the original and the new or the revised lease and see whether it is applicable for the practical expedient or not. First situation, lease term was 10 years. Okay. Lease rentals were 1 lakh per annum. Or 1 lakh per month, let's say. 1 lakh per month. And the ROU asset was 1000 square feet of building. Now I revise. How is the revision happening? Let's say the revision happened like this, that the lease term was also 10 years. There's no change. My lease rentals from 1 lakh have reduced only to 50,000 rupees per month. And my ROU asset is still the same. It is the same 1050. Now, provided this reduction is only applicable up to 30th of June 2021, then you can say that the practical expedient is applicable. But if the reduction of lease rental is available up to 30th of July 2021, then the applicability is not there. You cannot apply this practical expedient if the reduction in lease rental is beyond 30th June 2021. You might come up and say, sir, at least until 30th June reduction, I will take the bonus. No, not available. It has to be a reduction only up to 30th June 21 and not beyond. Now, doesn't make sense. I'll clarify, no problem. Yes, it doesn't make sense. Because obviously, even on 30th June 2021, you find that there's a significant situations there where people are not allowed to resume their operations. I agree. Let's say lease term was 10 years. Lease rental was the same 1 lakh rupee per month. And your ROU asset was very much the same, the 1000 SFT. Now I revised it. How did I revise it? I revised it like this. My lease term is still 10 years. However, my lease rentals became 50,000 rupees per month, while the ROU asset, instead of 1000 SFT, today I have agreed to occupy only 700 SFT. there's a surrender of a part of the ROU asset. When there's a surrender of a part of the ROU asset, clearly this is not applicable because there should only be a reduction in lease rental, no significant changes or no substantial changes to the other conditions of the lease. Correct? Let's say lease term is 10 years, lease rental is 1 lakh, same thing. My ROU asset is 1000 SFT. Now let's see what are the revised conditions. My lease term today has become only 7 years. My lease rentals have become 50,000 rupees per month. Reduction. My ROU asset predominantly remained the same. I will still consider it as 1000 SFT. Is the practical expedient applicable here? The practical expedient is not applicable because there is a significant change in the lease term. Because of this lease term change here, I cannot apply this practical expedient. Here it is not applicable because your ROU asset has been reduced to 700 SFT. But here it is applicable if the change or if the reduction in lease rental is only up to 30th June 2021. Now let's understand what is the practical expedient applicable. You are only talking about practical expedient is applicable or not applicable or not. I said it is applicable if the lease rentals have substantially remained the same or have reduced for any payment which falls due up to 30th June and there is no substantial change in any other lease term. What is the benefit? What is the relief? It is applicable in these scenarios, I agree. But what is the relief then? I'll talk about what is the relief now. Let us assume. Okay, let us assume. I'm giving you a situation perfectly which fits into this clause. My commencement of lease let's say was 1st of April 2019. On that day they have agreed for a lease term of 5 years. The lease rentals for ease of calculation, I'm taking per annum. I agree. It should have been monthly basis. Generally, lease rentals are paid monthly, but I'm taking per annum for the ease of our calculation. There is no IRR, but let's say the IBR at this point of time was about 10%. Again, ease of calculation. So I'm taking the interest rate implicit from lease or IBR at 10%. Let's say here came the crucial point. Lease reduction which was applicable from 1st April 2020 up to 31st March 2021. One full year he has reduced the lease and the lease rental supposed to be paid was only 50,000 per annum. You tell me, if I don't give you relief under COVID, what would have been your accounting treatment? This is simply a change, correct? A simple lease modification. There has to be a change in the value of lease liability. Same effect I will give it to even to your ROU asset as well. Let's see. First of all, what is the initial measurement? Initial measurement. I can write like this. The value of ROU asset on first measurement is equal to the value of lease liability as well and that can be given like this: 1 lakh for 5 years at 10% discount rate. 1 lakh lease rentals into present value annuity factor of 10.5. 10% for 5 years, calculate. 1 divided by 1.1, 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, GT 3.7908. So the amount would have been rupee 3,79,080. Okay, rounding it off. Would have been 079 actually. I'm writing it as 080. Fine. When did it change? This initial measurement was on 1st of April 2019. 2019-20 year, there was no COVID. So obviously it ran normally. So tell me, what was the measurement of your lease liability and what was your measurement of RUSA on 31st of March 2020? 31st of March 2020 or 1st April 2020? When the modification actually happened. Subsequent measurement. On 31st of March 2020. Before COVID actually affected us. Or affected this particular lease contract. What is the value of your ROU asset? ROU asset is equal to, it was actually recognized at 3,79,080 when it had a lease term of 5 years. So I would have written it like this. 3,79,080 minus depreciation during the year, 3,79,080 divided by 5. 3,79,080 The answer of your ROU asset would have been 3,03,264. What is the value of lease liability on that date? Lease liability on that date. What was the opening lease liability? 3,79,080. How do I measure, subsequently measure the lease liability? Add it with the amount of interest, reduce it with the repayment. Add it with the amount of interest. What is the interest? Incremental borrowing rate, which is 10% plus 37,908 minus 1 lakh. Interest at the rate of 10% minus lease payment of 1 lakh. You will get a final answer of how much? 3,79,080 plus 10% minus 1 lakh, 3,16,988. This would have been the measurement of ROU asset and the lease liability on 31st of March 2020. If suppose, due to lease modification, I did not apply practical expedient. If I did not know that this particular relief was available, then what I would have done? Then you tell me what you would have done. If there was no practical expedient applicable, I would have straightforward understood the paragraphs and applied the paragraphs of Ind AS 116 that we have discussed earlier under lease modification by trying to reduce the value of lease liability. Calculate. On 1st April 2020, that is the date on which the modification happened, I try to determine what is the amount of lease liability. My lease liability, which is revised, due to a change in lease rental. What was the change in lease rental? Look up, Papao. Earlier, I assumed that 1 lakh was the lease rental every year. But for 1 year period, starting from 1st April to 31st March in 2020-21, the lease rental should only be considered as 50,000 rupees per annum. So calculate. It would have been 50,000 rupees per annum multiplied by present value factor of 10,1. Another 4 years of lease are existing. First year, I am paying 50,000. For the next year onwards, I will pay 1 lakh into present value annuity factors of 10% for 2 years up to 5 years. Up to 4 years. Not 5 years. 1 year is already gone. 2 years up to 4 years. Calculate. Only 4 more years of lease term after the first year. 1 divided by 1.1. This would have been 50,000 into 0.909 plus 1 lakh. Find out what is the PVF. 4 years, 1 divided by 1.1. 4. From 2nd year to 3rd year to 4th year. So 2nd, 3rd, and 4th, only 3 years. Deduct, first find out up to 4 years, deduct the first year PVF. You'll get an answer of 2.2608. Now you calculate what is the amount. 50,000 into 0.909 is 45,450. 1 lakh into 2.2608 is 2,26,080. If I add both of them, then I would be arriving at a figure of 2,71,530. Actually, if it was not revised, your lease liability would have been 3,16,988. Now it is 2,71,530 because there is a revision in lease rental. So tell me, what is the reduction in lease liability? Reduction in lease liability is equal to, what was the amount of lease liability earlier? 3,16,988 minus 271,530. What would have been the reduction? Tell me. 3,16,988 minus 2,71,530, 45,458, 45,458. What is the entry that you would have passed here? The entry that I would have passed here is reduction in lease liability. So therefore, I would have passed the entry as lease liability account debit. ROU asset. How much value? I've already calculated the reduction. The same amount of reduction, I'll reduce it from lease liability. I'll also reduce it from the value of ROU asset. This is the entry that I would have recorded if I was not having a relief. Now, this is not having a relief. Now, you might always come up and say, sir, I don't find these computations very difficult. I find that these computations are quite simple to me. I find that going like this is fine. What great difference does it make? Just one calculation, right? Only one calculation for lease modification was necessary. I don't find that there is a significant requirement of a COVID relief into Ind AS 116 where I have to learn and mug up one more paragraph from Ind AS 116. I agree. I understand you have a problem. I'll tell you. this computation here became very, very simple to you because I was talking about the lease modification in a manner where the lease rentals were paid on a monthly basis, in an annual basis. But, and that too, for your simplicity, I have taken only 5 years. If the lease was a long-term lease, and if majority of the situation, lease rentals are supposed to be paid periodically on month on month. So if it is a monthly amount, then you think about what is the computation. I have to make sure that the modification is applied on a monthly basis. Monthly. I have to keep on identifying the reduction. And I have to arrive at what is the amount of lease modification or reduction in lease rentals or reduction in lease liability due to the modification to lease rent. Wouldn't have been as easy as we have calculated on a per annum basis. And for the simplicity, I took 5 years. What if it was 20 years of lease? What if it was 15 years of lease? Would you find it so easy to calculate? Now, for your understanding, I've done this. We have already learned this particular aspect, so it might look easy to you. But as such, if I apply in a practical scenario, this becomes very difficult. And I'll tell you one more thing. For your ease, I have also considered the lease reduction only for the exact financial year. Exactly, the lease reduction started from 1st April 2020, ended on 31st March 2021. What if it would have gone up to 30th June 2021, which is accepted by this practical expedient? Then I would have had a change in the next year lease also, where the next year only 3 months reduction in lease. Ram Ram, I can't do so much of changes. So what the standard comes up with the logic says that we can understand your difficulty in doing a lease modification under this scenario. Earlier, probably lease modification was an isolated case. Earlier, probably it was an isolated case where maybe one enterprise could have got it. Otherwise, normally there was no lease modification over the entire lease term. It was an abnormal event. But once COVID has come and we find that there is a significant lockdowns which are being applied by the state and the central governments, we need to understand that this COVID phenomena of reduction in lease rentals today has become or 60 or 70% cases. 60 to 70% of the cases, you find that this particular reduction or a complete waiver of lease rental has been up. So, that is the reason why it was necessary for inserting a temporary provision.